Hi all. Today we are going to see basic elements of digital signal processing. So we will be learning about basic elements of digital signal processing by understanding each word, like what do you mean by digital, what do you mean by signal, and what do you mean by processing of digital signal, processing of digital signal. So once we understand what is the meaning of digital signal processing, then in order to process that like digital signal, what are the elements we need, what are the elements, essential elements we are required to achieve this digital signal processing, we are going to understand. Okay. So first thing is signal. Signal is a function. For instance, like f of x equals to sine of x. So this is one of the function, right? So it is a function which conveys useful information. So if you see this particular function, we know that how the f of x changes with respect to, right? So it is basically sinusoidally changing. So if I want to plot this, so I have x in my x-axis, and like in the y-axis I have sine x. So if I want to plot this, it will be sinusoidal shift, right? So it has some useful information. I know that, like, if I, by looking into the signal, I can say it's a sinusoidal shift, and I can append or like I can modify this signal accordingly to have some useful other information as well, like during transmitting some waves in the wireless communication. Next is digital signal. So we have two types of signal. One is analog signal and another is digital signal. Analog signals are basically continuous and time varying signal. Okay, continuous time varying signal. So for instance, when I consider a sinusoidal waveform, I have value at all t, right? So t, this is like t, and this is x of t. I have value at all the value of t. So even if I measure at t equals to 1 or t equals to 0.05, I will have some values. Whereas in the digital signal, these are all derived from the discrete signal. Discrete signal in the sense, these are all not continuous signal. I will have discrete value. So n will be integer. This is n and I will have x of n. So I will have n values are only discrete in nature. In the sense, n equals to 0, n equals to 1, maybe n equals to some value. Maybe I will take 100. These are all digital discrete values. And for this, I will have some amplitudes also. Let me consider. This amplitude is 0.3. This amplitude is 0.7, so on. And this is basically discrete signal. And this I will be converting into digital signal. So these values I will convert from up to digital value, and I will be representing, for instance, 0.7, I will represent equivalent digital value. It can be something like, for instance, 0.111. This is an example. It may not be a correct value. So in this way I will be converting into digital value. If you see here, the values will be like either 0 or 1. In digital I can have only 1 or 0, or like I can say it's a true or false. So next topic is basically we learned about digital signal and analog signal, and like we learned about what we mean by signal. So next we should see what do we mean by processing of that signal. So we learned about digital signal, now we need to see what is the processing. Processing is nothing but we'll be performing certain operation on these signals. So for instance, when if I consider a simple sinusoidal signal, which is of continuous in nature, that is like analog signal. So if I want to change the amplitude of it, I need to amplify it. So this is one of the operation, right? That I need to increase the, so it's like in your speech signal, if you want to increase the volume of this signal, like t, and this is x1 of t, this is x2 of t. This is one operation, simple operation, that is amplification. Or like, let me consider this is in an analog domain, and like that is like we call it as analog signal processing. So in the digital signal processing, you have one signal. X of n, yeah, okay. This is 0, 1, 2, 3. Now if you want to delay this, okay, if you want to delay this, maybe shifting right. So I can say 0, at 1, nothing will be there. 2 and 3 and this 4. In this way, this is time shifting, right? So n is x dash of n. This is one kind of operation. This is basically digital signal processing. So we will be performing certain operations. These are also like simple operation, but we will be performing something like finding the spectrum of a signal. We will be performing some kind of operations like filtering. All these things we'll be doing in the digital signal processing. Okay. So in order to do this analog or digital signal processing, right? So we need certain elements or components. So we will see what are the various elements are required in order to do this digital signal processing. So if you consider analog signal processing, we will have input, that is analog input, that is real-time input, and we will have analog signal processing components, and we will have analog. So these analog signal processing components can be filters, mixers, right, amplifiers, etc. But whereas in case of digital signal processing, we will have input, that is again analog input. Because any real-time signals like speech or voltage, that will be in analog in nature. What we will be doing, we will be using one component called analog to digital converter. So this will convert into binary values. So we can have serial bus or parallel bus depending on our requirement. So this is basically zeros and ones. This is digital in value. This we will be feeding into digital signal processors. And this output, whatever we get, again output of digital signal processor is digital. But what we can hear, that is real-time signals, right, that is all analog in nature. Again, we cannot like see or like hear analog digital, right? So we need again one component called digital to analog, and we can hear that. Okay, that is again here, or like in case of video, we can see it. This is all. So these DSPs are basically, it's not hardware component like in analog, it's not filters or mixers. So these are all implemented using softwares. So these things are implemented using softwares. So the advantage is, in case of analog signal processor, if something goes bad, So you may have to redesign entire thing. But whereas in case of digital signal processor, if you want to reconfigure your design, okay, like all these filters, mixers, amplifiers, all are implemented as software, right? So you can just make changes in the software, and this software can be reconfigured and you can perform those operations, right? So that's the advantage of DSP, I can say. Whereas analog signal processing, it's costly to modify and implement. So whereas in the digital signal processing, it's easy to modify, easy to implement, and it will save like a lot of cost. And like in present scenario, most of the signal processing are done in the analog digital design, because like if you see your cell phone or smartphone itself, there are like a lot of signal processing are happening, right? Whatever the incoming wireless waves are coming, that is being demodulated and like down converted and is being like decoded into voice or video data, right? There are like a lot of signal processing. So thank you.